Well, like we all know, the solution of a problem is within the environment that that problem is. And the solution of the disease that we have, most diseases are environmental based. Environmental factors play a very strong role in what we see as a disease today. So if it's the food we eat, if it is the environment we live, if the environment is polluted, we're getting toxicant into our system, which causes dysregulation in the system and we lead to disease condition. If it's water that we drink, if our water is polluted, we're taking polluted water, polluted food into our system, it interacts with our system and causes dysregulation. And those dysregulation that is caused generate free radical that attack us. The free radical attack our system, make us to age faster, make us to succumb to disease condition faster, and all of those things. Then when you talk about this type of viruses that we have, where does this virus live? They live in animals. Where do some of these animals come from? From filthy environment. If our environment is not secure, we don't have good water to drink, we don't have good food to eat, we don't get medication and all of those things. So when your system is down and this virus come into your house, either by mistake or by your own action, by not taking care of yourself, then it start devastating the system and it will lead to disease condition, death ensue. We have coronavirus, we are running up and down. Now in America now, they cancel flights coming in into the country. If you are going anywhere, you are going to be quarantined for 14 days because you will be released. But the issue now becomes, what is the role of scientists? The scientist has to understand the etiology of the disease to be able to tackle what is wrong and how does that pathology ensue, and then develop drug or system to be able to combat it. And as a toxicologist are both therapeutic and trying to figure out how to prevent toxin from causing problem. So in the process of doing that, you contribute to drug development. You contribute to how you can keep your environment clean, sanitized, and all of those things. You know the animal that carries that virus. You know the animal that can infect your home. What do? You have to keep them out of your home. So this is one of those things that we do. And then we advocate for health. Advocate for health in the sense that when you go to a doctor or you're a scientist that have an idea, you tell people this water that is staying here is attracting mosquito, clean it out. Your house, you have all filth around, rat lives in there. They enter into your house, pee on your food, you have some virus going there. Yeah. So all of those things are the things that are important. And that is why the young mind that we have today, we have to develop them to be able to carry the baton forward and reduce the incidence of disease and burden of serious disease like diabetes, hypertension, stroke that have now become everyday life for even young people. There are some diseases we used to call disease of old. Now it's not disease of old anymore. It's the disease of the young people. So these are those things that are challenging our society. And as a toxicologist, as a pharmacologist, as a drug developer, we have to tackle it headlong and also carry the young people along with us so that they develop the tools to be able to combat the future challenges that is there. And the future challenge that we have is in the environment. All over the years, we have drugs that are within our environment, because our herbs, our food, our condiments, they are all medicine for us to use to cure our problems. But there's nothing like, you say, African disease. There's no disease that is African in origin per se. The disease is evenly distributed all over the world. It might be because of the fact that the climate of one place will lead to one more disease than the other one. But some diseases are because of habits. And because of habit, you can have some characters. Obesity, for example, diabetes, for example, was not our disease before. It's when we started eating like a European, then we start having the disease. So when we started behaving like European, we start having the disease. This used to be their own disease. Now we have inherited it. So there's no disease that is African. But one thing that is important is that we have herbs all around, which in my lab, I take herbs, I break it down, I induce disease condition, I treat them, and they resolve some of those conditions that are pathologic and cause problem for the people. So what we need to do is to train like all these young scientists that are here to know, not only as look for toxicologist aspect, to look for therapeutic aspect. We are working on those aspects. We are synthesizing them, we are characterizing them, we are evaluating the effect they have on cancer cell line, on stroke, neuroprotection, on diabetes, and all sort of hypertension. We have published all of them. So the issue moving forward is for us Africans to believe in our own local environment. But unfortunately, we are allowing companies to come to cut our herbal plant away right now. We are doing that right now. As we are doing it, it's going to cost us money down the road. Why? Because they have the money, they pump the money into this system and are developing this drug. Tomorrow they are going to sell it to us at $20,000, $100,000, which we cannot afford. So the government and all private enterprise need to show up and then help to develop some of those that we have proven to be efficacious in some of these disease conditions so that we can tackle them.